the Gemara Daf Tzadik Beis, actually the last line on Daf Tzadik Aleph on the Beis. Amalei Ravine L'Ravashi. Mi Omar Rabbi Yechanan Hachi. Did Rabbi Yechanan say, so Rashi says, did Rabbi Yechanan say that the halacha is like Rab Shimon? What's Rab Shimon's opinion? That without an aid of Chatzeres, all outdoor areas are considered to be one area you can carry from one Chatzer to another Chatzer, from a Chatzer to a Mavui, to a Karfiv, to a Gag. It's outdoors, it's not the main area where a place lives, you can carry from one to another. But Rabbi Yechanan said, halacha k'stam mishneh, that we paskin like a stam mishneh, and there's a stam mishneh, we learned this before here in Eidavin, kaisel shebein shtei chatzeres, a wall between two chatzeres, gavoya asara v'reichav arba, and the wall is tall 10 tfachim, and it's wide 4 tfachim. Ma'arv mishnayim, so since the wall separates the two chatzeres, you have to make two separate eid of chatzeres. Ve'ein ma'arv v'nechad. You cannot join them in one eid of chatzeres. In other words, they can't join together in one eid of chatzeres because there's a wall between them, so each one is separate. Then the Mishnah there says, Hayu b'roishe peiris, if on top of his wall, on top of this wall, this peiris, Eilo oilem mikan v'ayichlem, Eilo oilem mikan v'ayichlem. People from one side can eat fruits on top of the wall, and the people of the other side can eat the fruits on top of the wall. The wall itself is 4 tefachim wide. It's like a Rosh Hashanah Yachid for itself. They can each go up on top of the wall and use items that are there. But then the Mishnah said, Ubulvad shelo yeridu lemata. But they shouldn't bring anything that's on top of this wall down into the chotzer. Now what means lemata? So the question of the Gemara is, why can't you bring from the top of the wall into the chatzah? If we're going to paskin like Rab Shimon says, in any outdoor areas, you can bring from one chatzah to another, from one place to another. So why shouldn't you be able to bring the peiris that are on top of the wall into the chatzah, even without an aid of chatzeres? Answers the Gemara, my lamato, lamato labatim. You're allowed to bring it down to the chotzer. You're not allowed to bring it down and bring it into your house. That's what the Mishnah meant to say. Frek the Gemara. So therefore, it's not a stira to what Rabbi Yechanan says. Rabbi Yechanan paskins like Rab Shimon, and he also paskins like this Stam Mishnah. Frek the Gemara. But va'tani Rab Chiya, didn't Rab Chiya say uvavad shelo yehei ze oimid b'mkayme va'oichol v'ze oimid b'mkayme va'oichol? So the lashon of Rab Chiya was that they shouldn't stand near the wall and take down fruits from the wall and eat there, standing in the chatzer, not bringing it to your house. So he answered him, "V'chi Rabbi loishana." If Rabbi didn't learn in the Mishnah this lashon that Rab Chiya says, Rab Chiya minayin loy. How does Rab Chiya know to learn it in this Mishnah in the Braisa with this lashon? So Rabbi was Rab Chiya's teacher. So if Rabbi in the Mishnah he was Masada the Mishnayis, and he wrote the shot in the Mishnah, don't bring it down lamato. He didn't say ayim ibn kaimai. If Rabbi said don't bring it down lamato, and Rabbi did not say ayim ibn kaimai, it means not to bring it to the house. So therefore we don't rely on the lashon that it said here in the Braisa that Rab Chiya said, even ayim ibn kaimai. Interesting. Even though bederach klal, the Braises spell out and explain what it says in the Mishnah more bekitzer. But over here, because of this question, and we want to paskin like the Stam Mishnah, so the Gemara says, no, the Stam Mishnah that didn't spell out this detail, we can't say that paskin like the Stam Mishnah includes this detail as well, which was not spelled out in the Braisa, in the Mishnah that is. There's a famous word that Chassidim would say, Bederech Hatzachus, on this Lashon of the Gemara, V'chi Rebbe Leishon Rebchi Menayin Loi. Chassidim would explain why they travel to a Rebbe at least once a year, even though it takes off so much time, and it's such a tirche, and such a long distance. If you don't go to the Rebbe at least once a year, how could you have any chayis? How could you have any life? That's the word that Chassidim would say. We learned the machlokes. You have two courtyards, and v'churva achas b'neim, and there's a ruined house in between them. Achas irva, one of these chatzeres made an eid of chatzeres with the houses in that chatzer. V'achas lo irva. And another courtyard did not make an eid of chatzeres with the houses in its chatzer. Okay, if you want to see a picture, let's see if they have a picture over here. We're in the tzaddik beis over here. This time they have a picture for this.
We
had this before, yeah. But you can take a look in picture tof kof mem beis. Okay, two chatzeres with a broken down house in the middle. Now, the shayla is going to be, are they allowed to carry from their chatzeres to this broken down house? So one chatzer made a native chatzeres. Another chatzer did not make a native chatzeres. So this connects back to what we learned before, that Rav said. If you remember, Rav said, regarding carrying from one chatzer to another chatzer, it's actually better if you did not make an Eruv Chatzeres. Because if you did not make an Eruv Chatzeres with the houses, that means you're not bringing out any kelim from your houses into the chatzer. So therefore, whatever you're going to carry from one chatzer to another chatzer is not going to come from your house. You're not allowed to carry from your house to the chatzer to another chatzer. You're allowed to carry from a chatzer to another chatzer. So if you made an Eruv Chatzeres, so then you're going to bring things from your house into the chatzer. And then you're going to bring it from the chatzer into another chatzer. If you did not make an Erev chatzeres, it's better. You won't bring it out from your house. So that's what this is based on. So let's see.
You can bring it all to the chorba.
To the chorba. So now we're talking about bringing from your chatzer into this other chatzer, which is a chorba in between. Omer Rav Hone, says Rav Hone, Neisnen Aisa Lezu Shaloi Irva. The rights, the ability to carry is given to the one that did not make an Erev Chatzeres, because the one that did not make an Erev Chatzeres, there's no chashash he's going to bring out any kelim from his house, so he could carry it to the churva. So it belongs to him. And he could use it without an Erev Chatzeres. Aval l'she'ir v'loy, but the one that did make an Erev Chatzeres with the houses in his chatzer, so like Rav said before already, v'choshish is going to bring the kelim from the house to the chatzer, so he can't use this churva. Dilme asi lafuki money debatim l'churva. Because we're chayshish that now that he made an Erev Chatzeres with the houses, he's going to bring the kelim from his house into the churva. This is what Rav Huna said. Chiyah barav oma, but Chiyah said in the name of his father Rav, af l'she'irva. No, both of these Chatzeres, the one that is Irva, the one that's not Irva, they're both the same. That's what he heard from his father. And then Rav Chiyah, explained what his father meant. U'shteyan asuris. What his father meant to say is, both of them are going to be asur. Just like the one that did make an Erev Chatzeres. We're concerned that he's going to bring kelim from the house into this chatzer. We're also going to make a gzeira. We're going to be gezer and asa. Even the one that did not make an Erev Chatzeres should also be asa. So they shouldn't confuse. They made a gzeira to asa both of them. And he explains. In Taimar, again, so as Rashi explains this, Chia heard from his father Rav only these two words. Af l'she'irva. That both Irva and Loi Irva are the same. But now he's explaining that what his father meant to say is that they're both going to be aser. And he explains why he interpreted his father's words this way. If you're going to say that what my father meant, that both chatzeres, the one that made an Erev and one that did not, are both going to be mutter to carry to this churva, if so, go back to a regular case of a chatzer. When you have two chatzeres side by side. So why if you have two chatzeres side by side? One chatzer made an Erev chatzeres with the houses, and another chatzer did not make an Erev chatzeres with the houses. What's the halacha that Rav said before? The chatzer that made an Erev chatzeres with the houses, so you can't carry out to the other chatzer. Well, Choshesh is going to bring the kelim out. And the chatzer that did not make an Erev chatzeres, you could carry from this chatzer to the other chatzer, because we're not, he can't bring the kelim out of his house. So over there we see Rav Asrid. So if you're going to say over here mutarais, that both of these chatzeres can carry with this churba, so then I see that you can carry even from the chatzer that you did not make an Erev chatzeres with, or even from the chatzer that you did make an Erev chatzeres with. Why? There should be a chashash that you're going to carry out the kelim from your house. So therefore my father must have meant shteyen asurais. So the Gemara says, no, lav dafka, there's a difference. Some keeping the mintri money, the button, the chatzer. Over there, in Rav's halacha, that you're not allowed to carry from one chatzer to another chatzer when you did make an Erev chatzeres. So mintri bani the chatzer, money the bottom of chatzer. The kelim that you bring out, so it's the derech, it's shchiach, it's normal for a person to bring out his kelim into a chatzer and then into another chatzer. And therefore we're afraid, osila afuki, that a person might bring out the kelim from his house into the chatzer and then into another chatzer. Hacha b'churbe, here we're speaking about a ruined house. Since it's not common, it's not a place where a person keeps his kelim there. The gzeira of Chazal or the gzeira of Rav that he said that if you did make an Erev Chatzeres from your house, that you might bring out your kelim from your house into this ruined house, they weren't gezeira that. This is a milsad leishchicha, because a churve is not a place where a person usually brings his kelim to keep them there. It's a churve, it's a broken down place. So therefore you can't compare it to the gzeira of Rav. So the Gemara is concluding, maybe Rav, Taki, in this case, would say that shteyim mutaris, that they're both mutar. So now the Gemara brings another version that this is taka what Chiya bar Rav said l'chatchila. Ikid Amri, Chiya bar Rav Amar, Chiya bar Rav said, Af l'she'irvo. He said in the name of his father that the two chatzeres on both sides of the chatzer can carry into Irve. Or shtei mutaris. What my father meant to say is that both of them could carry into this korva. Ve'im toima shtei en asurais. Now if you're going to say that they're both asur, lefi she'ein noisnim. Just like the halacha is that if you have a chatzer where you made an eid of chatzeres with the houses, so you're going to be afraid to allow them to carry to another chatzer because they are the kalim of the house that they might carry out. Should we apply the same gzeira here as well? No, it's not the same thing as we said before. Hasam kim the mintri money the bottom bechatzer leisharabu rabbanan dasi lafuki. In a case where you have one chatzer and another chatzer next door, we're taka afraid that you're going to carry the kelim from one chatzer to another. That's a common thing. Avo bechorba loy mintri. But when you have a ruined house in between, that's a place that the kelim are not usually kept there, so that's not a shchiach thing for a person to do. So the gzeir of the rabbanan doesn't apply there. The lashon that the rishayim here say is we always have a klal milsud leishchiach legazer be rabbanan. So carrying to a churba, Rav would be made that we don't apply this gzeira. Zok the Mishneh, gag, godel, samuch, lekotn. You have a big rooftop that's near a small rooftop. So this is, we had this before already, but if you look again, in picture, tof kuf mem gimel. Two houses near each other, and a large rooftop near a small rooftop. So what's the halacha? A godel mutter. So this Rashi explains, what we're talking about now is, a person wants to carry kalim from the house into the rooftop, from the house inside. That's the issue over here. Not to carry just within the rooftop, to carry from your house to your rooftop. So you have an opening of a gadol to cotton. So the halacha is a gadol mutter. In the larger rooftop, you can carry the kalim from your house to the rooftop, but a cotton mutter, also that is. But in the smaller rooftop, you can't carry the kalim from your house into the smaller rooftop. So let me remind you again what this is based on. Anytime you have a chotzer, even though it's surrounded with a wall and a chayrat, a regular shusay yachad, but if this place is open to another chotzer, completely open, parutz to another chotzer that you did not make an erev chatzeres with, because it's parutz to another chotzer you didn't make an erev chatzeres with, you're not allowed to carry more than dal ramas in this chotzer, and you can't carry from your house into this chatzah, because it's parutz to another chatzah that it's asa to.
And how big is it?
Okay. Oh, no. Oh, so what's the chiluk? The chiluk is the big rooftop, so we say good asik. Okay, good asik, that there's imaginary mechitzis that come up. But if you look at the picture, this big rooftop has imaginary mechitzis that's coming up on all four sides, because even on the side where it's attached to the small house, but on the sides, it's sticking out. Because it's sticking out, it has also walls that are coming up over there that separates it from the small roof. The small rooftop doesn't have that. On the fourth side, it's completely open to the big house.
What if the connection is longer than 10 amas?
If the connection is?
The connection between the godel and the katan is longer than 10 amas.
So it's parutz, too much, you're saying?
Yeah.
I don't remember now the shear, but you might have a point about that. If it's more than 10 amas, then it's considered to be totally open, and it doesn't help that it has on the side. I don't remember now. Those parts on the side that it sticks out is called gifufi. It's a little mechitza on the side. So it could be if it's more than 10 amas, it's an issue. We learned about it in the second pedic. I don't remember right now. Zok the Mishnah Vayta, the same idea in another case. Chatzer gedoyah l'shenifritzer l'shenifritzer l'ktana. You have a big chatzer that's open to a small chatzer, which is the next picture. Picture Tav Kuf Mem Dalet. So it's the same inyan. What happens then? Gedoyah muteres. So the large chatzah is going to be mutter because it has, even on that side where it's open to the small chatzah, but it has the walls on the side that are enclosing it. But ktana asura, the ktana is going to be asur because the ktana is totally exposed to the big chatzah. So therefore you're not allowed to carry from the house into the small chatzah. Oh, so the Mishnah says it. Mipnei shi kepischa shal gedoyla. Because the small chatzah is completely open to the gedoyla. It becomes like tuffle to the gedoyla. And if you didn't make a eruv chatzeres with the gedoyla, so you can't carry from the house into the ktana. The ktana is now part of the gedoyla. You didn't make an eruv chatzeres altogether.
Why wouldn't that work?
I didn't have a father.
Because there is two walls, it's like closed.
Right.
The Ketana Tomei is just because it's like one.
Completely open.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That's what we had before.
Yeah, we had this before.
Well, are, now you're saying that.
No, same malacha, that's what it's saying here, no?
But you're allowed to go to the Ketana. From the Gdelet to the Ketana, you're allowed to go.
We're not talking now about going from the Gdelet to the Ketana. Sorry, I'm missing what you're saying. From the house into the Gdelet, from the house into the Chatzah Ketana.
Why we're not worried that he's going to actually walk through?
Huh?
Why we're not worried Xerah
days? No, that's not what we're talking about. There's no such Xerah. Not what we're talking about. If you didn't make a Erev Chatzeres with another Chatzah, you're not allowed to carry from one to another. The shail is if you're allowed to take from the house into the Chatzah. Okay, Zakta Gemara, Lama Lila Misni Tarti. Why is the Mishnah saying these two cases of a small roof and a big roof, a small Chatzah and a big Chatzah, it's the same thing? Zakta Gemara as follows. L'Rav Katoni Gag Dum Yid Chatzah. According to Rav, so this goes back to what Rav holds before, Rav holds that you do not say good asik when you have mechitzes that are below, but they are not minker, they're not noticeable. So what Rav is saying over here is, gag dum yud chotzer. Ma chotzer minker mechitzte. Just like with a chotzer, it has real mechitzes that are around it that you could see. Av gag nami minker mechitzte. So to buy a gag, you have to have mechitzes that you could see. What does that mean? What's Rav saying? L'chayre, between the large rooftop and the small rooftop, don't you have mechitzes? Why can't you say good asik in between to separate these two rooftops? The answer is you don't say it. Why not? Because they're attached. And because they're attached, the walls on the bottom are not noticeable. So that's what Rav was trying to teach you. Just like by a chotzer, the walls are minker, there you can see them, they're physical walls, so too the mechitzah has to be minker. And therefore the walls on the bottom are not minker, so you don't draw it up, you don't say good asik. L'shmul, Shmuel that says that you do say good asik even when the walls on the bottom in the house are not minker. Gag dum yid chatzer, he also says we compare the agag to chatzer, but in a different sense. Ma chatzer the kadarsi la rabim. Just like in a chatzer, when a rabim can walk straight through between the gdoila and the ketana, so therefore it's open. That's considered to be open because they can walk straight through. There's no mechitzah there. Agnami the kadarsi la rabim. Shmuel holds Taka that there is a concept that you raise up the mechitzes that are not minker, that are below inside the house, but that's only, we learned this before already, that's only if there are not a lot of people that are walking through in the gag on the top. But over here, because there's people that are walking back and forth, so therefore they're stepping over that imaginary mechitzes, so it doesn't help it, it doesn't do anything. So now the Gemara is going to bring a few different halachas.
So why does he have to say the case of chotzer? Why didn't he just say the case of gag?
So enachanami, according to this, the whole chiddush of the Mishnah is to teach from chotzer to gag. Now the Gemara is going to explain a few different examples. Nafkimin al halacha b'negei to a large chotzer and a small chotzer. Yosef Rabbe v'Rabbe Zeide v'Rabbe Baruch v'Rabbe Chanon v'Yosef Abaye Gabay v'Yosef Ka'amri, and they said as follows. I could see from the Mishnah, the Yuri Gedoyla Biketana, the large chatzah, the people that live in the large chatzah, they sort of have a rulership over the small chatzah. In other words, the small chatzah is completely open to them, so therefore it becomes like tuffle to the large chatzah. But Ve'ein the Yuri Ketana Bigedoyla, but the small chatzah does not rule over the big chatzah. Because the small chatzah, the large chatzah actually, the large chatzah has proper walls that are separating the small chatzah from it. The small chatzah doesn't have proper walls separating the large chatzah, so therefore the small chatzah becomes totally tuffle to the big chatzah does not become tuffle to the small chatzah. So the first example the Gemara brings in Afkamina from this would be to the halach of Kelayim. Ketzad, so something like Fanim Begedoyla, a person planted a vineyard in the large chatzah. So now the small chatzah is tuffled to the gedoyla. So asal isroya saktana, you can't plant vegetables in the small chatzah. Because when you plant it first in the large chatzah, your vineyard, it's as if that vineyard is going over also into the ketana. The ketana is tuffled to this. So it's like one big field. So you can't plant in the ketana any zroyim. Ve'im zora, if you did plant, zroyim asurim. The zroyim that you planted, they're going to be asur because it's as if you planted it together with the vineyard. Because the small chatzah is like tuffle to the big chatzah which has a vineyard in it. But gefanim mutarim. Even after you planted vegetables in the small chatzah, the gefanim are still going to be mutar because it has the walls that separate. The large chatzah is not tuffle to the small chatzah, it's separated. On the other hand, gefanim b'ketana, if you first go and plant gefanim in the small chatzah, So now the small chatzar is separated from the big chatzar. The big chatzar does not become tuffel to the small chatzar. So you planted your vineyard in the small chatzar. So the large chatzar is still considered to be separated from that. Mutil is raya esagdaila. You're allowed to go plant in the big chatzar, and it's going to be considered separated from each other. Okay, so Rashi's strat over here is, the point is, what did you plant first? The Gemara actually is, according to Rashi, is just giving an example when you get to the vineyard versus a field of vegetables. But the main thing that matters is not whether you planted your vineyard first or you planted your vegetables first. The main thing that matters is, where did you plant first? Did you plant first in the small one? If you first planted whatever it was in the small one, so then the status of the big one does not become tuffle to the small one, because it has those walls that separate it. So you can go and plant in the big one whatever you want. If you first planted in the big one, so then the small chatzah becomes tuffle to the big chatzah, so you can't plant in the small chatzah. That's Rashi's pshat. Taisus disagrees with this, because Taisus says, ultimately, once you plant, you first planted in the small chatzar, now the big chatzar is l'chayda separate, because it has walls that separate it, but once you plant now in the big chatzar, and the zroyim are growing, and they become very close to each other, so now, once you planted in the big one, so l'chayda the small one becomes tuffel to the big one. So l'chayda, sof, either way, after the fact, once you planted, it becomes mixed. So what's the pshat in the Gemara? It's a big question on Rashi. So Taisus learns the pshat is completely different. It's not about what you planted first, but it's actually about the kerem. Dafka, if you planted, not where you planted first, did you plant in the small one first or in the large one first? But Taisus is medayik, in the Lashon of the Pasuk, an interesting thing. It says, le sizra karmacha klayim. Only an area which is a kerem, which has the status and the name of a kerem, there you're not allowed to plant vegetables. If you have a field, a vegetable field or a wheat field, whatever it is, in there you're allowed to plant a vineyard. The whole issur is in your vineyard not to put zrayim. In your zrayim you're allowed to put a kerem. So therefore, if you planted in the small chatzah first, again, one second. If you planted in the small chatzah first, the status of the small chatzah does not create the status of the big chatzah. If you planted in the small chatzah became a kerem. Does the big chatzah become a kerem now? No, because it has the walls in between. The big chatzah is never going to be tuffle to the small chatzah. So the small chatzah is going to be your vineyard. The large chatzah is never going to have a named vineyard. It's always going to be just a sodah. So there you can plant zrayim as much as you want. After you plant the zrayim, it's going to be considered to be mixed with the vineyard. But where is it mixed? It's mixed in a sada. There's no issa to plant in a field a vineyard. The issa is to plant in the vineyard a field. Shenken the other way around. If you planted your vineyard in the big field, so that status of the big field goes into the small field because the small field is tuffle. The small chatzah is tuffle to your kerem. So now the small chatzah has a name kerem. So now you can't plant over there any zrayim because it's that is also a kerem. That's Taisus' strat.
It
makes
sense.
Huh?
This doesn't make sense.
It's a kasev. It's a kasev. Yes, it's a kasev. And not leisizra sotcha kerem. That's what Taisus is medayik. Mamish just saying. We learned 2 days ago, correct. Zakta Gemara Vaita, another example where you have an afkemina of a large chatzah that's open to a small chatzah. When you throw a get to an isha, you give a get to an isha, it doesn't have to land afka in her hand, it could land also in her chatzar. So isha begedoyla na. One of the deeds, so this is Rashi's pshat in the Gemara, that in order for the get that falls into her chatzar to be able to be good, that she received it, is that she has to be standing in the chatzar. She's not standing in the chatzar, then it doesn't, she's not kind. So now, how about isha begedoyla? She's standing in the large chatzar, the get beketana, and the get landed in the small chatzar. Misgareshes. So it's going to be a good gedishin, because the small chatzar is tuffle to the big chatzar. So the get that landed in the small chatzar, it's like it landed in the big chatzar, and she's standing there. But isha beketana, if she's standing in the small chatzar, the get begedoyla, and the get lands in the large chatzar, ain't it misgareshes? Because the large chatzar is not tuffle. The large chatzar is a separate thing. So the get landed in a different place where she's not standing there. That's Rashi's pshat in the Gemara. Taisus disagrees with this. Taisus says, Isha has to stand nearby. She doesn't have to necessarily be mamish in the same chatzah. So that's not pshat in the Gemara. Taisus says, the pshat in the Gemara is pashat, a different pshat. What's going on over here is that her husband lent her one of these two chatzeres. And the shayla is, which chatzah did he lend her? If he lent her, if he was shayl to her, the large chatzah. So then, even if the get landed in the small chatzer, he did never lenter that, but because he lenter the large chatzer, the small chatzer is going to become toffel to it. If he lenter the small chatzer, and then the get landed in the large chatzer, so he was shoyel her the small chatzer. The large chatzer is never going to be toffel to that. So therefore the gedishin won't be chal. That's Tosfos's pshat. Another example where you have an afkimin al halacha is tzibur b'gedoyla. You have a minion that's in a large chatzer. The shliach tzibur that's going to be davening and being mitzi everybody. It's befrat then that the shliach tzibur used to daven and be mitzi everybody. So the shliach tzibur standing b'ketana yaitze yidei chavasim. They're going to be yaitze because the place where the shliach tzibur is toffel to where the tzibur is, so he can daven for them. But if it's the other way around, tzibur b'ketana. If the tzibur is in the small chotzer and the shliach tzibur is b'gedayla, ein yaitze yidei chavasim. Because the place where the shliach tzibur is, which is in the gedayla, is not going to become toffel to the ketana. And most of the people are in the ketana, and they're not going to become toffel to him because they're most of the people. The roiv, the whole minion, can't become toffel to the shliach tzibur, and he's now in the gedayla. So therefore, you can't daven in such a way. Similar also, b'negeta minion b'chlal. If you have part of the minion in one place and part of the minion in another place, tisha b'gedayla, 9 people of your minion are in the large chotzer, v'yochid b'ketana. And there's a yachid in the smaller chatzah, mitzdarfin, so then there could be mitzdarf, because the small chatzah with one person becomes tafel to the gdaila. Tisha b'ktana, you have 9 people that are in a small chatzah, v'echad b'gdaila, 1 person in the large chatzah, ein mitzdarfin, because the person that's in the large chatzah does not become tafel to the 9 people that are in the small chatzah, and also the other way around, Rashi explains, as I said before, the people that are in the small chatzah will not become tafel to the large chatzah because they're deroif. The roiv never becomes toffel to the mir, to the one person. So the simple can't be mitzdarif.
But the minion porch is now.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. But over there, there's more shilas because over there, there's other things that are being mafsik. And over here, we're talking mamish about this case of 2 chatzeres that are directly open to each other, or 2 rooms that are directly open to each other. Even when they're directly open to each other, you have to look, huh?
Here and here.
The mushroom, small room, right? If this door would be open, so you have, if would have most of the tzibur over here, and just one person in the gedayla, so then it's a shaila, it's a problem. If you have most of the tzibur b'gedayla, and you have one person in the ketana, so then the ketana becomes tough to the gedayla. This is brought in Shulchan Aruch, Allah Adal, whatever brings it.
Right.
Yeah, it says the halacha of rayin, but I believe over here, even if they are rayin. Altareva there says taka rayin, but I think over here the halacha is, even if the rayin zeh, they're still not mitzdarev. Rayan is when you have 2 different areas, not Gdoyla and Ketana. But I think by Gdoyla and Ketana, it's even if Rayan. I believe so. Well, you have to understand another thing. Over here, it's talking about when you have part of your minion in one room and part of your minion in another room. How about if you have a full minion in one room, and then you have one person that wants to be mitzdarev to the minion? So there, the halacha might be different. Al-Tarem Shulchan Aruch doesn't say the fetish about this. I think the Pais can speak about it. Let's say there's a shul, and the shul has a minion. They don't need you for the minion. And you're like in the hallway, and the door is open, and you're davening Shemai Nesra outside. Could you be mitzdarev to the minion that's already there? So there's a svara to say that over here we're talking about creating the minion. Over here there's a problem. But once there's a minion and you're standing outside, maybe you're going to be nigrat after the minion.
But over here, chatz is 2 reshus. Over here is 1 reshus. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter that 2 chadarim with 1 reshus.
It's 2 reshus as far as the ownership is concerned.
Correct.
So, but as for minion, the ownership doesn't make any difference. So it's for all practical purposes, these 2 chatzeres are 1 large area.
Right?
No, 2 different people. In the dugma that we were speaking about in the Mishnah regarding erev chatzeres, it belongs to 2 different people. But for the minion, it doesn't make a difference who the owner is.
Yeah.
Zok the Mishnah, the Gemara Vayte, another nafke min al halacha would be tzoya. So the halacha is in unclean areas. If the tzoya, you're not allowed to daven there. So if the tzoya is big doyla, also, likris kriyishma b'ketana. You can't say kriyishma and the ketana because it's like you're standing mamish in the presence of the tzaya because the ketana follows the gdaila. Tzaya b'ketana. But if it's in the small chatzah and you're in the gdaila, muta likris kriyishma b'gdaila. Because it's like a separate, there's like walls that are separating, it separates them from each other. Okay, but over here in this case of tzaya, it also has to be far enough that there's no smell and you can't see it. It's not just gdaila and ketana, it's not just good enough. So Abaye says, in Cain, Matzino mechitze le iser. Comes out an interesting thing over here that the mechitze creates an iser. Why? Shel male ein mechitze. If there was no mechitze, marchik dal adames v'zireya. What's the halacha by klein? Going back to the halacha of klein. If you don't have a mechitze and you're planting a vineyard besides zrayim, so you just make it 4 amas away and you can plant it. But v'ilu hashte, now asura. It's not, now it's not going to be enough to be marchik dalaramis. Why? Because what did we say before? If you planted your vineyard in the gedayla, you can't plant any zrayim in the katana because the katana becomes totally tuffle to the gedayla. Even if it was, even if you're going to separate them four amas, it's not going to help you. The katana is tuffle to the gedayla, and it's always going to be asur. So it comes out a funny thing. If you have one large area, so then you just have marchik four amas. Now, because I have a pesashtikul mechitza here, it's going to become even more lechumra. That now, even if I'm going to be marchik dalat amas, I'm going to say that the katana is tough with the gedolah and you can't plant there. Mod nezach. Amalei Rav Zeira.
Who said that?
Huh? So Rashi bavarned it before. I should have spelled it out before. But when the Gemara before spoke about the fact that the katana is tuffle to the gedayla, it means even if you marchik dalat amas. Otherwise, there'd be no chiddush. Because if you're being marchik dalat amas and you're going to say that then it's mutter, so then mine afkemine, katana, gedayla, the shir always is dalat amas. You just marchik dalat amas and that's it. The chiddush before was, even though you wore marchik dalat amas, the katana is still going to be tuffle to the gedayla. So this, the next, the hemshach of the sugya, we'll start the scene, but the whole hemshach of the inyan we'll learn tomorrow, Mitzvah Shem, is going to be talking about the scene, that it comes out that a mechitza creates even more of a chumrah. Don't we find that a mechitza could create an iser? But now, in our mission we learned, chatzah gedayla shenifritza lektana, small chatzah that it's open to a small chatzah, so gedayla moteres. In the gedayla you can carry from your house into the chatzah. The ketana asura, but in the ketana you're not allowed. B'pnei shehi kepischa shel gedayla, because the ketana is like, it's totally open to the gedayla. Now, so the Gemara says, in this Mishnah, what happens? V'ilu hishva is gifufeha. How about if you were mashvet, you built another mechitza there. If you built another mechitza, what does the Gemara mean when it says built another mechitza? So take a look and picture Tav Kuf Mem Hei. Right? Compare picture Tav Kuf Mem Hei. You have it in Rashi, exactly. Compare picture Tav Kuf Mem Hei to picture Tav Kuf Mem Dalet. So you see, in Tav Kuf Mem Dalet, so you have a larger chatzah and a smaller chatzah. So you have what separates them, those gifufi on the side. But how about over here in the larger, in picture Tav Kuf Mem Hei, he built another wall. He built another wall, and now both chatzahs are the same thing. It's like just one long chatzah between the two houses. What happens then? Because you added another wall here, it's going to become now a bigger chumrah. Now you're not going to be allowed to carry from either house into this chatzah. Before, when you didn't have that additional wall that you built from the house into the large chatzah, you could carry from the house into the small chatzah, you can't carry. Now you added this wall, it became one large chatzah, and you're not allowed to carry there at all. So what do I see? I see an example. Again, the ilu hishvas gifufel, if you were mashve it, those walls that were sticking, those chelik that were sticking out, now you made it equal, and it's all like one big chatzah, gedayla nami asura. You're going to be also to carry from the house into the gedayla as well. So what do I see over here? Adding a mechitza creates a chumra. So the Gemara says, no, that's not an example. Amalei hasam, you're not adding a mechitza. Silik mechitza su. By adding this wall, you're removing that mechitza from the sides that separated the large chatza from the big chatza. You're not adding a mechitza, adarabi, you're removing the mechitza. But the question still remains, where do we find such a concept that when you add a mechitza, that creates a bigger chumra? And the Gemara in the Hamshach is going to bring different examples of such a thing.